around my ear. I just realised it was still there. Ian Hemphill has the nickname Herbie for very good reason. He's an expert with more than 40 years' experience dealing with spices and herbs, and his Bible about them is one of the world's best reference books for cooks. And he joins us on the couch now, Clay. Your whole family is involved in herbs and spices. How did that come
yes,
to be?
Yes, my mother, whose name is Rosemary Hemphill, and she was christened Rosemary. It wasn't a pen name.
Oh.
She was the first Australian to write a book on herbs in 1959. So I grew up in a household where herbs and spices were around us all the time. Mum was experimenting with recipes. And I think I just absorbed so much by osmosis, probably without even realising it. And then in my later years of school, of course, everyone in Australia gets a nickname. Having parents in the herb business, the legal herb business, that is, was a little bit unusual, so my friends gave me the nickname Herbie.
That's right.
And, that's your story. And
that's
my
dad, absolutely.
That's right, because if it was the illegal herb business, your nickname would be Hempy.
Well, that's why my surname's Hemphill.
That's right.
And you've brought in some pretty amazing-looking stuff. What is it?
Yeah.
What are all those different herbs you've brought?
Well, what we've got here, I've brought a selection of peppercorns, because peppercorns are very common, we use them, but everyone uses black peppercorns. There are white peppercorns that come from the same Piper nigrum vine, but they're processed differently to remove the skin so that they actually remain white and they don't turn black on drying. We've got pink peppercorns, which are not actually a true pepper, but they come from a tree that is related to the pepper trees you see growing in Australian parks.
Do they all taste the same?
No, quite different. So the black peppercorn has got a lot of piper and oil in it.
Yes.
When you freshly crack black pepper, you get that beautiful aroma.
Mm.
White pepper has very little flavour, but it is hotter than black pepper. And that's the one that tends to be used when you want to add a pepper heat, but you don't want to overpower with a pepper flavour.
And the pink one?
Pink one is very pine-like. It's almost a bit like juniper. It's actually not very peppery. It's a bit of a misnomer that it's called pink pepper. But you would use it like juniper with very rich food. Then over at the end there, there is the Sichuan pepper, and that is one that is used very much in Asian cooking. It's very numbing on the palate. So, you know, if you have too much of it, your mouth will go completely numb.
Yeah.
But it has a beautiful tangy flavour that complements Chinese food very well. The ones, the funny little long ones there that look a bit like rat's droppings, are actually called Selim pepper from Central Africa. Those ones, very unusual, give a beautiful flavour to a slow-cooked stew or casserole. And in the recipe, in the book, The Spice and Herb Bible, there's a recipe for a buka stew, which is absolutely gorgeous. Another pepper is long pepper. Yes, you'll have to interrupt me, I do.
There's lots and lots of types of peppers. You've actually brought in a few different others to talk about as well. We've got cinnamon.
So here we have cinnamon quills.
Mm-hmm.
Now, the one that Tanya's holding, this one here, is a cinnamon quill from the true cinnamon tree from Sri Lanka.
Wow.
And this quill is actually handmade, like making a cigar, where they strip off the outer layer of bark, they peel the underneath layer.
Does it smell nice?
Beautiful.
Nice.
When you break it.
Oh, that's lovely.
And
smell that, Ita.
All those pieces are rolled, beautiful. Literally like making a giant cigar.
Wow.
And then it's dried, and that's what a true cinnamon quill is like.
How do you use it when you're cooking?
You either put the whole cinnamon quill into the dish while it's cooking. So you may be doing a spiced rice.
Or a stewed apple.
And stewed apple, absolutely, or cooking apple for apple pie, whatever. Put the cinnamon quill in. During cooking, the flavour will infuse into the dish. Take it out at the end of cooking. But then if you want, say, cinnamon in your porridge, which I do, which means I don't feel the need for putting sugar in my porridge, I use ground cinnamon. So you use ground cinnamon when you want it to mix with other ingredients, making cakes or biscuits, whatever. Whole when you want to simply infuse it, but you don't want lots of powder through that particular dish.
Ian, how long do spices last?
On average, a whole spice will last about 3 years.
Oh.
Once you grind it, the flavour will diminish more rapidly. They never go off, but they will gradually lose their flavour. And you noticed how strong the cinnamon smelt when it was broken. Because you've broken the spice, you've started to release the volatile oils, that means the shelf life will be shorter. So your ground spices will usually only last about 12 to 18 months. So they should always be kept in a well-sealed container, away from extremes of heat and light and humidity, and buy small amounts. And if it's a spice you don't use very often, buy whole spice and then grind a little bit up that you need when you need to use it in cooking.
Right. Well, Ian Hemphill's Spice and Herb Bible covers nearly 100 items and includes more than 170 recipes. It's available in all good bookshops. And Ian is giving away his butter chicken spice mix to everyone in the audience. You can have a bit of a go cooking at home. Let's thank Ian Hemphill, everyone. Congratulations on the book. Right, still to come on Studio 10, Craig Bennett and all the news in showbiz. Don't go anywhere.